Alrighty, welcome to the finals of our 29-player event today here at General Games. We have Charles Byers and Kyle R.
yeah, there's some mouthfuls for you.
Yeah, my name is Scott. I'm here with Marcus in the booth.
How you doing?
These two players have played 5 rounds of Swiss with a cut to top 4.
Yes.
Charles was actually top of Swiss.
Yeah, very good player. He was my one loss for the day.
Mm.
It was a mirror match, and he plays the deck incredibly well.
So he's playing Imperial Armory, Vader, and the Tusken Raider,
yes,
as you can see here.
Yes.
Opponent Kyle Iyer is playing the two hide guns and the Akbar list. This list has been a topic for discussion recently. What do you think about it?
It's a very strong list. Deceptive amount of damage. I mean, Akbar doesn't do a whole lot on his own, but with the damage sides on the hide guns there, it can pump out damage so quickly. It can also move into another mode and actually just play like a Falcon on you, and then suddenly you're looking down the barrel of 4 damage.
Well, that's it. That's what the deck's supposed to do. It's using the two hide guns and Akbar for the two resource sides on their dice,
yes,
and it's just gonna generate as many resources as it can and play a Falcon or a Black One or a Launch Bay or something big like that, and then ride that to victory. Hopefully,
yeah, definitely. The deck has two ways to be played. Basically, you can just come out shooting, or you can play the longer game and build some resources.
I think that's what he wants to be doing. He wants to get as many resources as he can, so in the turns where he has to play the reversals, he has the reversal plus some spare money maybe play an Electro Shock or something like that.
Reversal's going to be a key card in this matchup. Reversing a 3 damage die back onto Vader is huge.
Yeah, or the Raider. Like, it could be anywhere.
Definitely.
The Raider has a 3 on it as well.
Yeah, definitely. There's a lot of damage getting thrown around. So they're both, looks like...
Vader's on the resource plan with a holocron focus.
Yeah.
We've got Akbar throwing a 2 focus, which is one of his best sides in this matchup.
Definitely.
He can use that 2 focus to turn both hide guns to resource, or his other die to a resource.
Yeah, definitely.
Just generate... If he rolls in 2 hide guns here and they get 1 resource, he's looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 resources potentially this turn.
Yeah, huge amount, which is theoretically a turn 1 Falcon if he has it in hand.
That's the dream, right?
Yeah, yeah. Best thing you can do in the game, right? So Charles is...
There's a resource.
So Charles is playing the pretty stock standard holocron out early, try and get something onto Vader without paying for it.
Good play there, he doesn't like you. Getting rid of that 2 focuses.
Yeah, yep, strong.
It's so important.
Yeah, I feel that Charles might run out of dice manipulation quite quickly in this matchup, because every turn... Carl's going to present dice that need to be dealt with.
There's the logistics there, getting 2 resources.
Yeah, big start. I mean, that's at worst now. If everything stays as is, he has the option to play Falcon as first action next turn.
Mm. Well, he's looking at a flank here, which is another great card in the matchup. It's a key card in the matchup, because it means you don't want to roll in too fast for fear of flank, and you don't want to roll in too slow,
because
then you're not in.
This is definitely going to be a very skill-intensive matchup.
Four-strike.
Yeah, 4-strike.
One of your favorite cards.
Oh, man. Vader's dice are just dangerous. Even if
they're showing blanks.
Even if they're showing blanks. I mean, an unpredictable one of Vader dice is still just... It feels great.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely not a... It doesn't feel bad. But, like I was saying, this matchup's going to be very skill-intensive. So it looks like Carl claims there to play the Survival Gear.
For 1, yep.
Yep.
Another card with 2 resource sides.
Yeah, definitely.
Got some shields, got some focus. It's just a good, decent card. Doesn't have a blank, so he's going to use that to generate more resources.
Yeah, just solid.
Maybe try and find
good
the big support cards a little later in the game.
Yeah, this Akbar deck definitely plays a lot of just value dice.
Double Electroshock in hand for Carl.
In this matchup, it's great, but it's also a little bad, because
it's a little awkward.
There are 3s, and sometimes you're stuck there looking at your Electroshock in hand, and you just can't deal with that 6 damage on Vader.
No, that's exactly right. He's got a Falcon. He's got it looks like a Launch Bay.
That could be... That's big. That's really big. Considering that Charles has already used one of his that he doesn't like use here. Which means that there's not many ways left for the Vader deck to actually remove the Launch Bay dice if it was to come out.
And that's it. Like, Isolation doesn't work. It's really, he doesn't like you, and Electroshock if they have a few cards.
Mm. Looks like Vader's teaching the Tusken Raider the ways of the Force. go figure. So Carl rolls in here. Looks like he hits a 2 for a resource, blank, and a resource by the look of it.
Yep, that looks about right.
Yeah.
At least maybe a plus one.
Or so Vader rolls back in.
Discarding a launch bay, though.
Discards the launch bay. Doesn't
want to see it. He might have a second later on.
Yeah, maybe he's not planning on... it's possible he feels that he just doesn't have time.
Well, he's three resources behind.
Yep. Yeah, definitely. He doesn't feel he's playing it this turn. There's no point holding on to it.
Holocron Special is scary here.
Yeah, I would very much consider Electroshocking that as my next play. You don't know what that card could
be. You don't
want
to turn to a mind probe.
Yeah, it could be nothing, or it could be a mind probe. Yeah. Chooses not to here, rolls an Akbar.
Gotta respect. He's got no respect for the Holocron Special here, which might just be the right play.
Oh,
here it is.
Here we go. Oh, four stroke.
Not as scary as Mind Probe, in my opinion, but
not
just
yet.
As relevant.
Not yet, but if Carl's plan is to play a Falcon, Force Throw is an incredible card. Yes.
Yeah, I once played a game where I had Ray with two Force Throws holding back a Falcon and a black one.
Yeah, yeah, the Force Throw is intimidating. It's very scary. It's very scary to roll any big die against because you could just be taking it.
Yeah, you could just eat the four damage.
Yep. Yeah, at worst, it's a onboard way. Oh, it's the lightsaber there, which is quite strong. It's an onboard way to just deal with the die. Basically, it's the Vader deck can very quickly run out of dice manipulation.
I see a Force Choke in Charles's hand there.
Yes. Again, no
Force
good...
Choke Holocron. Another Force Strike. He's just waiting.
He's just waiting. Sitting on his
one of those dice is going to turn to a three, and
it's... leaving his options open. So he's got a resource showing and a shield showing. So it doesn't want to commit to one or the other.
Also the focus on that.
Yeah, exactly. So he feels he might be able to just focus one to a three and then catch him off guard with the Force Strike. Five resources on Carl's side. Just go straight for the Force Strike.
Yep.
Okay.
Just get it done.
Yep.
He wants to claim. He wants to go first next turn.
Yeah, definitely.
Five resources. Smells a little bit like a Falcon to me.
That's a little scary. So he still looks like he's still holding... Oh, he's holding
He's got the double Electroshock
double
and Falcon. So that focus is really... It's really dangerous. Like, if he wants to get the extra resource because he wants to Electroshock that focus.
Yeah, for sure.
But it's too late. Charles has already... He's seen the writing on the wall and said, no, I can't afford to not
have
this
here. So this is where those Electroshocks are very awkward in the matchup. They do nothing.
Yeah, they want to hit the focus, not the three. And he just wanted the extra resource. He wants to play Electroshock, then play Falcon. But it's hard.
So... I feel the reason he didn't Electroshock earlier is he feels at this point in the matchup he has to play the Falcon this turn or he's falling too far behind. But if he was to spend the one resource to Electroshock the focus side, he then goes to four resources and doesn't know whether or not he's going to be able to get the fifth resource.
That's exactly right.
And it could, in doing that, then he's also potentially having to discard his other Electroshock to get the resource. So basically, he weathered three damage to take a strong board position, I feel. So rolls in three, discard. Oh, not what you want to be seeing against an opponent that has one card in hand. Pitches the reroll anyway to reroll. Rolls up some damage, some resources, and a focus.
So Falcon's showing two resources here.
Yeah. The focus might be changing.
Who knows?
That.
Maybe the Falcon's actually showing a four gun.
Yeah. So actually presenting potentially seven damage from these three dice.
Which is absolutely terrifying.
Yeah.
Seven is a huge amount.
That is a huge amount of damage.
Off three dice.
Yep. For the low cost of one resource.
There it is. Does Charles have an answer? He could only have... It's not what you know here, right?
I'm not sure if he's actually already claimed. I feel
he may have.
I feel Charles may have claimed Lizzie's previous action. Yeah, it looks like he did.
Sure, so it's just Carl taking his time.
Well, yeah, he's just considering his options here. Not many options to consider. I think he's just thinking about who he's actually going to be doing the damage to, obviously.
This is really important.
Like, yeah, this is huge.
Because he can do seven to the Tusken Raider and put it on one,
which
means he can just dispense of it with any random dice.
Yes.
But... killing Vader is the most important thing.
Right now, I feel killing Vader is the correct action.
Well, he's got the Holocron. Charles has decided that Vader's going to have the gear this game.
Yep, exactly. Well, that's the thing. I mean, the Force Throw on Vader is potentially a very very large thorn in the side of the Falcon deck.
That's exactly right. So Vader's on seven.
Yeah, so
five left.
Big swing of health right there.
It's important having that extra health because it means he can't just get randomly dispatched by a Falcon.
Also important to note, no more Force Strikes.
That's exactly right.
So Akbar is on 6 health, but
Carl discarding that scavenge without before even seeing the dice roll. He doesn't care. He doesn't want that scavenge.
Yeah, he knows what he's pitching here.
There's the electroshock. The shock. Get that dice out of the pool, please, sir.
Was that a disrupt 2 that he electroshocked there?
It looks like a disrupt 2.
Yeah, okay. Interesting. So obviously wants to hold up.
He just wants to get rid of the dice. He wants to use his electroshocks to get rid of his dice.
Wants to hold up resources. Better have one resource and lose an electroshock than have no resources and not be able to play it.
I think he really wants to kill Vader this turn. If he can kill Vader this turn, the game is pretty much done.
He has a very strong chance of doing just that.
Mm.
Even just off the hide guns, he has a chance of doing.
Yeah,
just
they
that.
Have a 3-side and a 2-side. Akbar's got a single gun, but he's got 2 focus. That's the power there.
Rolls in the Tusken Raider
plus 2 melee and a blank.
Misses the melee's not a terrible side.
It's not nothing. Scout for the other hide gun.
Plays the scout there. The focus on that with a Falcon die in the pool is so strong.
It's just terrifying. Like, I don't think Charles plays any way of removing the Falcon. There aren't that many ways in the game. There's not really. There's 2, actually.
No,
they're both red.
Yeah. To remove the Falcon from play, yeah, definitely. You are at the mercy of variants.
Surgical strike and ATST.
Yes, that is correct.
I heard a player today discuss the possibility of playing an ATST in his Janko deck for when the Hyperloop deck gets a bunch of resources. You'll also get resources. You slam an ATST and their day is ruined.
That could be. That's definitely a very heads-up meta decision.
That would be very funny. I'd love to see that.
That would be great.
I'd also love to see that cunning destroy the ATSD.
Yeah, all right,
back to the game. We got a 1 discard, we got a blank, and we got a gun from Akbar.
Pretty lackluster roll there.
The 1 discard side feels so random.
Oh, it's definitely. Well, no, it is a little synergistic when you consider Akbar's ability. And he's just dead. What did he die to there? Did we miss some damage on board? Oh, no, he hit the... We missed something. Oh, he focused. No, sorry. He focused the Tusken Raider into 1 damage.
Oh, yep. That's enough.
Yeah, with the 2 modifier, was able to dispatch of...
So we got the disrupt from the hired gun. We got... I think it's a melee. We'll have to check a bit earlier. We'll see what happens.
Looks like die getting removed by a 4-story special.
Mm-hmm. Other hired gun. So this is the thing. He's got 2... So Carl plays 2... second chances.
Yeah,
so 2 yellow characters left on the board.
Yep.
Charles has got a dispatch of one of them and then
also,
really hammer the other one.
Very important now to note that Charles has committed... basically, he's now at the mercy of that Falcon die.
Mm.
Without knowing his hand, he's keeping his claws very close to his chest. He could potentially be almost just dead this turn. Looks like Carl's got enough cards to do some re-rolling. Chooses to take the resources here. Interesting. Has a reversal in hand and a red card. I did not know. Actually, I don't know if that was red. That might have been a grey card.
We'll find out.
Still hasn't... No, important to note, still hasn't rolled in the Falcon.
No resources from either player, I believe.
No.
Limiting card selection, Sling Chronic.
Yeah, basically. Still has the option here to roll on the Falcon, just waiting to see what happens. It looks like we've actually had a judge call at the table, so my counterpart has stepped out to see what's going on. We will see what transpires from this. Not quite sure what would have caused it. The board state seems pretty clear. Perhaps some missed damage or possibly just a miscommunication. Looks like Charles is explaining to our head judge what is going on. Carl is simply looking. Chance there to see the hand. So we have a No Mercy in the hand. We have a Mind Probe. We have a Deflect. And we have a 4-stroke. Very strong hand. So
quick judge call there. There's a game space.
State error. So there was a judge call and it was a game state error, I believe.
Yeah, so the holocron die wasn't placed when it was played on Vader, and then Vader was rolled in, the holocron was missed.
That's okay.
Right. So it's a missed opportunity, it's okay. We just played on.
Okay.
Both players missed it. It's warnings all around, but not too bad for the game.
That's alright. Nothing detrimental. So chooses to roll in the Falcon, hits the 3 damage, instantly resolves it. Charles misses his shield there as it's reminded that he has that instead. And we go to the next round. Charles looking at a hand of upgrades here. Deflect, incredibly powerful versus the Falcon there.
Oh, it's huge. It's one of the best answers to it.
Yeah, I actually completely forgot about the fact that this deck generally plays two of those.
Mm.
It is a very good answer. Chooses to discard the four stroke, feeling that it is not...
Not very pertinent here?
Yeah, not great here. Little slow. Usually a card that you want to play and then upgrade into something a bit more powerful.
So you got to feel your anger there.
Yeah, the feel your anger, not... Super great. Given that there's a die in the pool,
there's two dies in this game doesn't have blanks. The survival gear also has no blanks.
So he's looking at the potential of only ever getting two blanks currently, which is...
But the guns have the blanks and the scouts have blanks.
Oh, scouts do have blanks, of course, yeah.
There's a hunker down. Not excellent in this matchup.
Pretty bad.
He comes a reversal.
Snap reversals. Hits the three. Was that a three? Yep, that's a dead Vader.
Yeah, that is the three. That's a huge reversal there. That would have been Carl's turn. He would have opened his hand, seen the reversal, thought, if Vader rolls a three, Vader's dead. That's the plan.
Yeah, it is a very powerful card in this matchup. It's interesting. It's possible that Charles should not have rolled in Vader there and actually tried to...
Bait with the Tusken Raider.
I mean, can he hit a disrupt? He could have hit a disrupt. No.
No disrupt on any of his other dice.
Basically, at the mercy of his own roll there... bit of a rough position to be in. Carl definitely set up for that. I feel he had the reversal in hand last turn.
Oh, yeah. Reversal's one of the key cards in this matchup. You just sit there, you build your whole turn around it. You think, if that rolls in that, I do that. If that rolls in that, I do that.
Yeah.
It's fantastic.
Very strong card, obviously, given... Particularly, it's expensive, but this deck's able to fund it.
Mm. If you've got the bankroll, you get the free damage.
You're playing with Falcons, mate. You've got the bankroll to cast them reversal.
Hunks of junk. So Falcon's still out of the pool yet. He's waiting until the end of the turn for that. I think he's playing around some sort of dice mitigation. He wants to try and maybe bait Charles into claiming the battlefield before he rolls in Falcon.
Yeah, that is the sort of hidden power of playing support cards in general. You are able to take nothing actions and just having more actions that do things.
Here's the scout. Look at his hand.
Allow you to draw out a turn more and to basically have a bit more control over what's going on.
Intimidate. He sees Feel Your Anger. He sees Deflect. Deflect doesn't do anything here because it's spot a blue character part.
Yeah, that's gone.
Feel Your Anger is still alive. We got a force throw in hand, I believe.
Mm. Interesting that he actually chose the Intimidate.
There's a lot of shields on survival gear.
Yeah, I suppose he feels that he's going to grind this game out a little bit slower.
If he rolls shields at all, it's Intimidate adds value, and Intimidate's going to do damage.
Definitely.
He may as well take away the card that does damage, I think.
Yeah, definitely, of course. It's almost the correct... Yeah, I feel like that is 100% correct decision, yeah, having thought about it now. What is interesting is having seen Charles' deck, I do know he's actually currently playing two Intimidates.
Ah, interesting. That's an unpopular choice.
Yes. A lot of decks aren't even playing one. I personally play one. I feel it's very strong. It's a good way to push through.
Well, it's another Scout special. This one will probably take the Feel Your Anger.
Yeah, exactly. Man, I really underestimated the power of Scout.
One sec, we just got to do a quick judge there.
No worries, another judge call. Hold on. Looks like we've had a bit of a play error. We've just, my co-commentator and head judge for the event has stepped out just to keep things in order. I wonder what happened there. What did we spot there? What happened?
Deflect needs to spot a blue character and he played it without having a blue character.
Yeah, of course, obviously, yeah. Very, very much not allowed. Players are going to have to be a little bit more cautious of... Be a bit more aware
of the game. It's an easy mistake to make.
Yeah, definitely.
You put it in the deck with a blue character, you get to use it what it does the whole day, and suddenly in the finals, you don't have a blue character anymore.
Yeah, definitely. It looks like, second scout gets resolved. Looks at a bunch of cards here.
I think he's taking Feel Your Anger. It's really one of the only cards with text.
Feel Your Anger, right now, 100% correct. Is there a No Mercy in there, or am I seeing things? There is a No Mercy.
You're seeing a No Mercy, you're seeing a Force Throw. But if you take the blue card, it does similar things.
Yeah, definitely. Deflect is...
There's a claim from Charles.
Deflect is, at this point, a piece of fuel for the No Mercy. There we go. So now he gets to roll in the Falcon.
Falcon discard three, maybe he just wants to get them all.
Jesus.
He's seen the hand twice, taking two cards, let's get rid of
feels
the other
he three. Does it. Feels he doesn't.
Nah, he just wants the damage here.
Yeah.
There it is, three guns. Is he happy with that? We'll find out.
Yep, that's a lot of damage.
I think he's happy with that.
That's a lot of damage. That's 5 damage there. Yep.
5 on the Tusken Raider.
Very strong.
Difficult game for Charles to come back from here.
Yeah, I feel right now the Raider is not well equipped enough to take this fight. When your Vader dies, generally, you want to have some stuff. Whatever it be, you want some stuff on your Raider. You want
like a Kylo Ren's lightsaber?
Well, that would
be there's
cheating.
One.
that would be cheating. No, you want. Yeah. No, you can't.
Really?
No. It's not. How do you play Kylo Ren on?
It doesn't say spot a blue character.
It's blue character only.
Oh, really?
It is a blue character only upgrade. You can play a regular lightsaber.
Is that because it's so shoddy? It needs a needs a decent wielder.
Yeah, exactly. Well, let's be honest. We all saw Kylo Ren fight. He wasn't the best. But no. So
there's the Falcon special. Are we looping? We looping natural?
No, there's a reversal in the bin.
There is a reversal in the bin.
That's all you need.
Charles is thinking.
That's all you need. If he has no way to, he has an electroshock in hand. I feel electroshocking.
I would like is a,
it is
there.
A snap,
there it is.
It is a snap decision.
Spotting a yellow character. There it is.
Yep.
You still got one.
It's one of the few sides of the Falcon you can actually electroshock.
That the 2 focus and the 2 resource are the 3.
Oh, it's true. There's 3. I apologize. 3. Yep. Makes
another scout special. Yes. Carl's going to play with full omniscience.
Oh well. I underestimated scouts.
Here comes the Raider.
So heavily.
It's got a good die. It's cheap. It's got a good die. Here we go. We got a shield. A force training special, which is deal 1 damage, gain 1 shield, or get a resource. 2 of those.
Yeah. Yeah. So generally, you want your Tusken Raider to have finished his force training and be versed in the ways of the force throw and the mind probe by now. but alas, Vader was dealt with quickly, so that was not possible. It's interesting, actually, that Charles has not seen a holocron yet, which...
Charles has seen a holocron special.
There's definitely a holocron in play, but yeah, has not seen the special yet.
He saw it before on Vader, but not since he put it on. Tusken Raider had it.
I feel it is correct to try and play to play the first holocron out on Vader to try and get some pressure out early on an already strong character with Vader. You know, you're rolling in 2 dice. You might as well be rolling in a mind probe or a force choke or something else quite strong. But you definitely need to simultaneously making the Raider much stronger. Otherwise, you end up in situations like this where the once your Vader has a dirt nap, you're a bit limited to how much
what
you can actually
What else
do.
Is in Charles's hand here?
Haven't...
Because Scout has to hit the cheapest card. Now, hit a Kylo Ren's lightsaber, so that's a very expensive card. Ooh. Here's another reversal. Off the Falcon special, was it?
Yeah. No. No, just that's from hand.
That's just a straight up.
Yep.
There it is. All right, we're going to go to game 2.
Yep. So these players will very quickly shuffle up, and we will go to game 2.
Interesting first match. Charles had a good start.
Yeah. Very strong start. The double force strikes very, very strong.
Carl just dominated the middle game there.
He
played a couple of upgrades, got his resources, slammed the Falcon, and rode it to victory.
Yes. The Falcon. Carl plays this very well. He prioritizes damage and resources correctly, and balances the 2 quite elegantly.
Yeah, it's really easy in this deck to just go way over the top on one or the other.
Sure,
you try
yeah.
and go way too far on the resources, and you find you're a little short on
yep.
supports later, or you go too heavy on the resources, you've got to deal damage at some point.
You roll in a hide gun, and you see a 3 damage, and you might just be tempted to simply deal 3, but generally speaking, that's probably the wrong play. You need those resources in going into the second and third turn.
Yeah, not only does it not gain you a resource, it removes a resource.
Yeah, exactly. The damage is important, but that's not the priority of the deck. The priority of the deck is to play things like Reversal and Falcon.
His Rebel War Room will help him resolve those hard gun specials without spending the precious resources.
What is interesting, obviously this is match play, so given that Charles was defeated in game 1, it is now assumed that he won the role.
Yeah, so he will choose the battlefield.
So he is given the choice.
And the thing is, he knows this but while mulliganing. This is not normally something you know while mulliganing.
No, it is a little bit of extra information. You know what you yeah, definitely.
You know which battlefield you're going to use.
Yep. I feel... What battlefield was Carl playing?
Rebel War Room.
I still feel it's correct for Charles to take his here, despite giving the 2 shields.
I think he just wants to get Vader in as fast as possible and deal as much damage.
Yeah, definitely. The armory is very, very strong for his deck. He's playing the upgrades to make it worthwhile. Also, just the war room enables just a little bit too much, too many choices for Carl's deck.
Well, it just makes a deck that really can't really claim. It gives it the ability to claim.
Yeah, exactly. It allows it to claim. It also allows it to get that cheeky damage through where you would normally have to pay a resource, you know?
Going first is very powerful in this game, and Carl definitely wants to. He wants to get Akbar in with the focuses and sculpt his whole turn around what Akbar rolls.
Yeah, definitely.
If Charles can deny that as much as possible, that's...
Yeah, definitely. Akbar is a bit of key to this deck. He is generally going to die first.
No, Akbar's a loose cannon. He'll roll in whatever he wants. He'll roll in the two focus, which is amazing with all the supports and the hired guns, and he'll just roll the random discard and snipe their last card, deal two damage. He's a secret assassin.
Yeah, definitely. Very, very strong. If you can... What is terrifying is having...
Carl mulliganing an Electroshock. Realize it's not as good as it was in other matchups.
No, not great against this matchup. Inherently...
It's still fine. The card is great.
It's an amazing card. It's very slightly conditional dice removal, which when you compare to some of the other dice removal in the game, it's one of the better ones.
It is definitely one of the better ones. We don't have complete unconditional dice removal apart from things like Force Throw.
Obviously.
That requires a condition.
The requirement is it needs to have been paid for, it needs to be in play, and you need to have rolled the special.
Yeah, I guess those are three conditions.
Yeah, so just a few.
What I just saw in Charlestown, I saw a couple of Force trainings.
Maybe the
Tusken Raider gets a little bit more...
Yeah, he's gonna try the training again.
Carl slips out the War Room just in case he wants to play it.
Just in case, give him the option.
Yeah, he might choose it, you never know.
The decision here is the relevance of the shields. Obviously, Charles taking his own battlefield, giving his opponent two shields, which can be very relevant.
It's true, sometimes the Vader deck just wants to do as much damage and doesn't matter what battlefield they're on.
Oh, definitely. Less relevant given that he is actually playing double Intimidate.
I think that's the reason.
He
wants to see it early.
It definitely affects the decision. Carl correctly shields up his Akbar, obviously very important for the matchup.
Holocron on the Tusken Raider.
Strong start here.
That is indicative of the previous match.
Strong start here. Feels
get that Holocron dice, Charles.
Yep, feels he wants to get... That looks like a Mind Probe, potentially, given... Based on rolls, yeah, that's a Mind Probe. Given the rolls, could see something. Looks like... Oh, there we go. Yep, no, they have remembered the Holocron die this time, which is good. Good to see. Alright, so... Chooses to roll in the...
Here comes Raider.
Here comes Raider.
Stellar, one resource and a blank.
Blank's on the...
Look, it's not that bad. Resource is great. The blank is obviously not great.
Look, he's going to be re-rolling.
But it's the early games, early days.
Akbar sees and raises with a few blanks.
I don't know if he's... He might even just call here. Is that a resource? Yeah, he calls.
He calls.
Resource and a couple of blanks.
So, rolls in Raider. Discards
cunning. Doesn't even care what the dice come. Two more resources. This is a money game for Charles.
Honestly, taking the resource here is not...
I'd be so tempted.
It's very tempting. Charles, being able to take those three resources and slam a force throw or a lightsaber. It looks like he's got a Mind Probe in hand. Being able to slam down a... Oh!
Here comes, it binds all things.
Okay, so it binds all things. He claims... Yeah, he can quite easily play a Mind Probe here. I feel he might even just claim.
He's got Mind Probe in his hand.
He has Mind Probe in hand.
Yeah, I would be super tempted here.
I'd be very tempted.
Vader's not looking at any damage. Carl's obviously on the resource gambit.
Yep, there it is. So he claims the resources. If you're Carl here, you're a little worried.
if I'm Carl, I'm terrified.
You're worried because that is very indicative of the fact that he is not going to
damage. There's a 3-gun. Maybe Charles wants to take a bit of time off and deal with that. I don't know what he can do. I can't quite see his hand.
I think he has... In hand, he has a Force Training, a Mind Probe. I'm not sure about the other card. Here we go. So now he's going to use the Binds All Things.
Play the straight on Vader.
Plays
like,
it out.
He's like, come on, Vads. You can survive a bit longer this time.
Yeah. That is horrifying.
Is he going to get the dice
see
that
if
one
he
as
remembers
well?
The die this time. So, yeah, we'll just make sure that he actually plays the die out.
You don't want to miss that die. That die is really powerful.
No, that is very important. So the jetpack is discarded to re-roll.
We're looking at one resource, one blank, one resource, three guns. So maybe he's hoping to get enough resources to resolve the damage as well.
Oh man, and he's able to play a backup muscle turn one.
Rolling in the money.
Oh, he's in a really strong spot here.
Five resources. Did we see if he had a Falcon in hand earlier? I missed it.
I don't believe
he
does.
No, reversal.
That is a reversal.
Well, that's pretty...
That is still quite strong. Very strong turn here.
Who's going to get the backup muscle? Is it going to be Akbar?
Look, I feel it has to be, right?
I feel the backup muscle is a really good one to lead with, because if he's got the Intimidate, he can remove the shields and still have that damage.
Yep. Yep. I feel it's incorrect to attempt to take
Charles
out
claims.
I feel it's incorrect to take out a hide gun in this matchup.
It's a shame Charles couldn't claim and play the. He had the backup muscle, so he had to wait. But shame he couldn't claim and use the bundle things to play the, the mind probe.
Yeah, of course. I mean, action. Your action efficiency is very important. I mean, backup muscle is a very strong card, but it does. It is slow. It is an action to play. It's an action to activate. And generally speaking, in the early turns of the game, you just don't have time.
You don't. You want to get it in.
You definitely want to get it in play as soon as possible. So,
it's very powerful on Tusken Raider.
Yes.
Because the Tusken Raider's ability means you can resolve it straight away and just steal five to them.
Yeah, of course. Very strong.
Is he a cunning in Carl's hand?
It is a cunning.
Cunning's really good with the mind probe.
That is not bad with the mind probe.
Or a holocron. Not really good with a holocron.
Not great with holocron. So it has a cunning, has a reversal by the look of it.
He kept the reversal from last turn?
Yep.
He's just got bankroll for days.
Charles?
Six resources.
Looks like Charles has a Kylo
Saber. There we go.
Kylo Saber,
holocron, force throw, Kylo Saber, and a force training.
Strong hand. And something else.
Holocron on Vader.
Holocron on Vader. Look, Vader's getting swole. Vader is getting big.
Two resources here for cunning on the hide gun.
Okay. Well, the cunning is a bit scary.
It means that next round, whoever rolls in first has a huge chance of just like spiking the opponent for five damage.
Oh yeah, the cunning can be a real problem.
Wow,
and the Kylo Saber.
This is a hell of a Vader.
This Vader is huge.
You thought it was hard to kill before.
Oh, the lightsabers on Vader are just.
Well, Kylo Saber has four damage.
They are oppressively strong.
Is that a three resource? Three for a resource?
That does look like a three for a resource.
It looks like one discard for cunning.
Yes, and a discard. So rolls Invader, discards,
hunker down.
Not great in this matchup, as previously mentioned.
Although there's some mind bullets on some of these upgrades.
Something about majority of faces being...
So we've got a damage side from Vader, a shield side from the Kylo Saber.
Yep.
Looks like we've got disrupt from Mind Probe. Reversal that to get it out of there.
Whoa, again, so strong.
Both reversals have been excellent here. Both hitting threes.
Yep. Yep, definitely. All the damage actually has come from reversal, which is interesting.
Seven left on Vader. That's still a lot.
Yeah, Vader's in a very strong spot here.
There's no Falcon to just strafing run him out of the game.
Nope. It's a lot of dice. So hits the shield and a blank.
Holocron's been less than average.
Radio has missed its force training, it would seem. Needs a bit more training. Needs to hit some art. Reconsiders. Interesting.
Wonder what he's thinking about.
So chooses to just resolve the damage.
Get the damage in. He doesn't like you. Get rid of it.
No. Feels like. If he was going to do the damage anyway, it's correct to just do it.
He leaves him with no resources.
Yes, but
he's at the mercy of Vader's reroll.
He is at the mercy, but I mean, if you're bluffing that you have something anyway, and you feel the way you're going to win this matchup is by pushing damage through, the bluff is worth less than the damage.
Yeah, that's fair. So here comes and it binds all things discarded to reroll a bunch of dice.
Yep. Big reroll coming here. This is where this amount of...
He's kept the two disrupt. He wants to keep Carl off the resource. He's seen what they do.
Heads up play there. Not a great roll. Doesn't look like he's got any bases.
There's a resource and some plus from the Kylo.
Yeah, not a great roll.
He's down to one Vader dice, so there's only two chances of, apart from the lightsaber, there's only two chances of base damage.
So, I think he'll probably consider pitching force training. Yep. Pitches the force training.
Even if he rolls the base damage on Tusken Raider, he needs a resource for it. He's a ways off doing a lot of damage this turn.
Yeah, definitely.
Shield, holocron special, this might be something. Has he still got a force training?
He has a force throw in hand.
Ah, nice.
So correctly discarded the right card, giving him the option now to actually do something with
Snipes the force throw. Doesn't want to see that. Does not want to see the holocron. Doesn't want to see Vader learn to force throw.
Is discarded.
Yeah, the cunning die is really interesting. It's got a really cool special. It's got some discards. Yep. It's just a really good utilitarian dice.
It's actually possible that Charles just simply missed the fact that there was a discard in play there.
Maybe he think Carl wouldn't use it. Maybe he's trying to reroll into special.
Definitely.
What are you going to do? You have to roll all your dice. You're not going to keep those blanks.
No, you definitely. He made the correct play. He discarded the correct card and rerolled the correct dice, and that's all you can do.
Two resources from Akbar. That might be exactly what Carl's looking for.
Vader's still got the still the two disrupt there.
Yes.
Interesting that he claimed one resource.
He claimed one, so they would use the two.
Yeah, baited him into it.
He just wanted to see what's up. He didn't want to fully commit to two.
Yeah.
Survival gear on the data pad.
Survival gear upgrades the data pad. With the claim. Okay, interesting. Yep, and now Charles passes turn.
Good claim.
Yep. Solid play there with the... solid play by claiming one resource, attempting to bait him in to overcommitting.
Alrighty, so he's got five fresh cards. Yep. What are we looking at? We're looking at a deflect. Vader's still very much alive this time.
Yes, we have a deflect, which is very much alive in this matchup now.
Well, not right now. We need a... Well, it's fine. It's just not as good as with the Falcons in play.
Oh, definitely. I mean, it's a card you want to see in the matchup.
Oh, definitely.
Almost at all times.
Yeah, like, if one of those high guns throws up a cheeky three, you'll happily deal two damage.
Hey, it's removal. I mean, obviously the damage is
there's
important,
a cunning
the
special.
Removal.
That's incredible here.
Oh, this is...
Charles is looking at the five cards and thinking that's all going to Vader's
that's
head.
That's scary. Now, it's possible. I think I saw may have seen an electroshock in Charles' hands. And if he has it, now is the time to use it.
So Charles has... five cards, which means Vader will go to one damage because of the shield.
Definitely has...
Rolling in Vader.
Reconsiders. Reconsiders.
So Force Choke, he doesn't like you.
No, it's a backup muscle.
Deflect, that's a backup muscle.
That's a backup muscle. Oh, that cunning special is huge.
Another Force Choke. Yeah, two Force Chokes. He doesn't like you, a deflect and a backup muscle.
Look, that one roll may have just...
may have sealed Vader's fate. He still goes to one. He's fine.
He goes to one, but it's not hard to push one. One damage is a lot more, easier to push through than...
So Charles's options were roll in Vader, hoping that Carl won't immediately resolve it, but he was always going to resolve it.
Yeah, he was 100%.
Charles knows this. He's just going to play the backup muscle and keep the game rolling.
Yeah, by playing the backup muscle, reduces the amount of damage Vader takes by one.
Exactly.
Only takes four instead of the five he would have taken by choosing to roll in Vader.
And he wants to have the backup muscle in play, so he has to just kick on, accept the loss.
Yeah, definitely. Needs to start prioritizing getting some gear out on the Raider here, because Vader is going to die. He needs to gear up his Raider.
That is one of the weaknesses of the Kylo and Luke's lightsabers. They do not have redeploy.
No
one else can pick him up.
Very, very strong card, but obviously redeploy less.
Your special from Kylo looks like shields on Vader, disrupt on Vader, and a discard on Mind Probe.
Plus
a plus one resource on Sith Hologram.
Yep. All right, again, Carl's considering options here. Pays one. Looks like he's going to electroshock the special. Yep.
That special just bang on Akbar's shields.
Yeah,
they're rolling again.
Shields are gone, and it's just a free shield removal there. So electroshocking, they're 100% correct. Feels he's obviously ahead. The cunning definitely did some work there.
The cunning is worth his weight in gold right now.
Discards two cards. Hits the second chance.
And the DL-44 heavy blaster pistol.
Very relevant.
That blast pistol would have been very relevant a little later in the game when Vader dies.
Oh, definitely.
Then the Tusken Raider down to only a few dice.
Well, even both those cards are super relevant.
Oh, yeah, second chance especially.
I feel that if Vader dies and it comes down to Tusken Raider versus anything, he's going to have a hard time winning through second chance simply based on the fact he only has 8 health.
Is the one the one damage from Tusken Raider?
Yep, the one melee damage and a blank on Holocron. That Holocron has not been good.
Holocron's a dud. It's a phony.
Yeah, it's
picked
a bad one.
The Caribbean market.
It's a bad one.
There's a resource. So we're looking at three resources and a disrupt for Carl. He could just claim those and be happy with this turn. He's done heaps.
Yeah, definitely in a very strong position here. I feel Charles is going to be going to town here. He's still got two Vader dice in the pool. He needs to get damage
through. Well, he needs to get value from Vader because he's not long for this world.
Yeah, he needs to get damage through. So he's pitching four stroke. Obviously feels it's a bit weak here to reroll. I feel you reroll leaves the disrupt. Okay. Oof.
Two blanks from Holocron.
That's an unlucky roll. Carl looking like he's in quite a commanding position this game now. It's turned around very quickly based on that cunning special.
That was huge.
Oh, that was massive.
That's why he's bleeding, right?
Oh, definitely. Discard scout to do some rerolls. Yeah, the cunning was massive. It definitely Charles had an amazingly fast start, and cunning just sort of rode on its coattails, and
this has been a huge that huge stuff from Charles has been great. I thought Carl was done, but the cunning is a great answer to it.
Oh, cunning definitely swung this match back. Granted, Charles did have an amazingly fast start, but didn't really push through much damage.
No, the rolls weren't on his side.
No, but he was going to be getting value in subsequent
Carl's
turns.
Removed Vader dies almost every time.
Yeah,
I saw a game today where the cunning resolved a opponent's thermal detonator and bombed his whole team, then discarded the thermal detonator. Cunning is some secret value.
Oh, that is about as good as a cunning gets. That's
no, cunning killing ATSD is the best it can get.
This is true. Blows itself up?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Nice. Yeah, so Carl, I was talking to Carl earlier after he won his top four match, actually. And he felt quite confident going into the matchup based on the fact that he just said that Charles's deck, the Vader Raider deck, is just weak to dice disruption, which is true. It's very powerful, but if you can answer the Vader dice on a semi-consistent level, its damage is
neutered, there's a special
neutered quite quickly.
Looks like the Raider's going to pick up a force choke.
Probably the he only has two cards, so it will be the choke.
Yeah.
Rerolling the dice here.
All right, making sure he rolls the holocron separately this time. It's important.
Yes, they are in two different places on two different characters.
Vader's right. Getting two shields. He just wants to stay alive. This is actually pushing Vader further out of reach for Carl. He's going to need
a little bit.
What's it? 3, 6, 9, 10, 11. He's on two health and two shields. That's a lot of damage for Carl to generate without any support.
Plays the force choke down.
Mm-hmm. Resolve the holocron special.
Resolving the
holocron. No resource. Yeah. No, there is a resource. Does he want to roll in? Nope. Just ending the turn.
Chooses not to play the holocron back out, which is interesting.
Maybe he wants to discard it. Might need it to reroll.
Maybe. Its side is very relevant. The faces on it are quite relevant. See if he remembers to grab his force. Yes, he is. He's grabbing his force track dice, which is good. Or die, rather.
Mm.
Okay, so we're into the next turn.
So keeping three resources, so not spending resources on the force choke dice. The force choke dice isn't great at the end of the turn.
Interesting that he doesn't play the holocron back out, but doesn't discard it either.
Maybe he just wants to claim the battle. I don't know. Maybe he wants to keep it to discard. I don't know. Maybe he wants to keep his options. Maybe he thinks that this turn he might discard it, but might play it.
Maybe.
Maybe he wants to see what he draws. It's a very powerful card.
It is very strong. It gives you options.
So he's keeping a resource last turn, lets him play lightsaber this turn?
Yeah, definitely. Very non-committal. Lightsaber, he's very good.
It really bolsters up the Tusken Raider.
Simply playing lightsaber out in Tusken Raider never feels bad.
The cunning focus.
Discards the logistics here. Mm. Not in need of any more money.
No. The focus on cunning is definitely not as good as the special here.
Nope.
But it is nothing to sneeze at.
Not quite as strong. There's the electro
shock. The special
hits,
again.
Hits the special again. Oh.
We got a focus from the holocron. That's pretty dangerous.
Yeah.
And is that the three mind bullets for the mind probe there?
That is the three mind bullets for a resource.
Carl definitely having the damage upper hand here.
Yeah, Charles' rolls have not been amazing, but at the same time, Carl has had a lot of dice manipulation.
He's just been all over him.
Yeah. Oh, here's the no mercy.
Spending the resources, playing the card.
Mind bullets for a lot?
Being very deliberate with his actions.
Did
here.
He have the no mercy in hand last time? Is that why he kept the holocron?
No, he didn't.
Maybe it was just a very heads-up play. maybe he just knows his deck better than we do. I feel that, yeah, it just empties his hand here. Does five with the mind bullets? Four with the mind bullets. Sorry, he adds... Adds three damage. So that's six damage. That's a... Wow. Wow, it's dead. He just... What? Didn't he have two shields?
He had four damage on it and a shield.
Oh, he had four damage. Yeah, I thought he had two damage
and
two shields.
Four damage.
Oh, okay.
No mercy reads, discarding a number of blue cards from your hand, then resolve one of your dice showing damage, increasing its value by one for each card you discard.
His chance of winning just went up exponentially, but he's still in a very tough position here.
His last card is Holocron, and if Carl is paying attention, he'd know that.
Yeah, he would know that he has nothing else in hand here.
It's just a reroll left?
It is a reroll. I feel that I feel he should be playing the holocron out on the Raider simply because Vader is going to die, and the only way he's winning this is making his Raider very big.
Mm. Unless he's trying to get six damage off the Vader.
Yeah, of course.
We got resources. We got another resource from Cunning. Is that two or three
two,
damage?
Two, I believe. I believe that's a two. I believe that's a two gun. Charles, essentially on the don't draw Falcon plan, I think, at the moment.
Smacking up that guy for three.
Yeah, he's on the hope Carl doesn't draw the Falcon.
Or the launch bay.
Or the launch
bay. Or the black one.
Yeah. not sure if Carl's actually playing black one.
That's true. He could not be. I'll check the list a bit later.
Yeah. I've definitely playing launch bay and definitely playing Falcon. Maybe feels that black one isn't as strong.
There's a special.
No.
It's not too bad.
It's not so good here. It's not so good here. But it does give him the option of the force throw, which isn't as relevant. It is extra damage.
Force throw? No, this mind probe.
The force choke, sorry.
Yeah, which is just... It's the same damage.
Chooses to, obviously, correctly choosing to empty his hand. So
yeah,
mind probe,
what's he going to do? Reroll Vader's dice into three and then have it force choked?
Mind probe is useless here. He can take the special of the lightsaber.
That's funny.
It's a essentially stripping the shields.
Yeah, that, and we'll see if Carl sees that line.
Does he get to roll the shield in? The die? We'll have to double check here. I think they've got a judge call to see whether or not by using the lightsaber special, he's actually able to roll in the die given the rules. I don't know the card text off the top of my head exactly word for word, so it's hard to know. Scott's just stepped out to check. Looks like we're just reading the card text. Generally rules questions like this can actually just be answered simply by reading the card text. And it usually becomes quite obvious when read very deliberately. So it looks like we have a ruling. It will be interesting to see which way. At worst, he still gets to resolve the special of the lightsaber, which is equivalent, which is basically stripping shields, and that does not feel bad. Would leave Vader back on 2 HP. So we have a ruling here. Looks like players know what's up. And they're currently just deciding. Carl's just deciding what he's going to do. Chooses to do the damage. And Vader. Yeah, Vader's dead. Vader would be dead to the cunning special. I believe. Yep. Yeah, two damage from the lightsaber kills Vader. Simply using the last Vader die there, simply because he has no option. He's going to die. Looks like the ruling was he does not get to roll in the lightsaber die.
So what cunning says is it lets you treat the card as yours, not the die as yours.
Oh, of course.
It's still the cunning die. You don't get to re-roll the...
Yeah, of course.
The mind probe. Yeah. Oh, sorry, the card
still, table. Still very strong there.
It's still two damage.
It was two damage. It would have been gravy if he got to roll the die in as well. Still was a good enough roll to kill Vader.
It's an interesting corner case.
Yeah, definitely. Now, first time I've thought about it, actually.
So two disrupt there, a plus one resource on a blank. It's a pretty sad mishmash of symbols.
Pretty lackluster roll.
So
here.
He could disrupt here to stop future Falcons popping up?
Yeah, he chose to just simply disrupt previously because it was the last thing Vader could do, and it definitely was correct. Yeah,
I agree with that play.
Look,
Carl's going to get a third, which is then probably going to turn into two more next turn, then play Falcon if he draws
it. I feel Carl just claims the resource here. So future turns, he rolls in, he hits any guns, he just lets them off.
That's exactly right.
Doesn't need to worry about...
Does Charles claim here, or does he use money? Or does he use backup muscle? He claims.
Nah, just claims.
He doesn't know which one he has to hit yet. You don't want to waste... Backup muscle only works three times.
Yeah, exactly.
So if he gets runner, Tusken Raider special... Oh, sorry, Tusken Raider 3 damage on that hide gun, he doesn't want to waste any of the superfluous damage with the hide gun.
Exactly. He's not pushed... he's not pushed to have to use it this turn. Oh, sees the 4-strike now.
Fury Ranger, 4-strike. It only hits blue dice, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's a bit unfortunate. It has to be a melee side.
So we've got force through, and on the other side, Carl's looking at a reversal, a scout, a DL-44 blaster, the Millennium Falcon, the man, the myth, the legend.
I think he just holds up
the survival gear.
I feel like if he holds up the reversal here, he can't really lose, unfortunately. What is interesting, given the fact that Charles only has one character left, he's not exactly going to be pushed to having to take lots of different actions. He's going to have the time to activate backup muscle as a nothing action almost.
Straight up just Falcon. If the Tusken Raider rolled at the 3, I feel he may have. But he's got the character lead, he's got the health lead, he's got the resource lead. He just pushed that advantage all the way
home. Well, if the Tusken Raider roll up anything of relevance, I feel Charles is definitely discarding the 4-strike to resolve it. So there we go. So he's got the time to activate the backup muscle.
Letting Falcon come in.
Yep. Falcon comes in, hits discard. Three discard.
Interesting side on that die. Sometimes you really want it, sometimes you really don't want it.
It's a very good way to shut your opponent out of a turn.
It is. But Carl probably knows Charles has a lot of dead cards in his deck now because Vader's gone. Like, the flex don't work anymore.
Yeah, I feel...
Force throw only comes off the Holocron special.
Yeah, Carl's playing very well. I feel like Carl is going to be rolling in the hide guns and simply going for some re-rolls here. I feel like he wants to push some damage through.
If he rolls the special on cunning, he can start force choking, and that's absurd.
Yeah. Actually, interestingly, he can't force choke the Raider.
No.
It says another character.
Another
interesting rules. I'd have to read the...
No, that is
cheating. Pointed out very quickly by Carl that he cannot do that.
Judge doesn't have to get involved here.
No, that's good. That's good. Obviously, we're not playing at a super high level of rules enforcement.
This is a relaxed tier tournament.
Yeah, quite relaxed. Just playing for the OP kit. So players
two
are...
Two OP kits.
Well, there was two.
Yeah, oh, we had 29 we had players today.
29 players here at General Games. Wow. Great turnout. Lot of very good players in the room, actually, now I think about it.
Good diverse field.
Yeah, definitely. Very, very strong top four we had.
Scouting Mind Probe.
Yeah.
Doesn't want to get walked into the cunning again.
Nope, nope, not going to play that one out. It's interesting, actually. A few corner cases come up here with cunning that
cunning
I've never
always does.
I've never considered before. It'd be actually interesting. I might check that out after to see whether or not you can actually force stroke the character with force stroke with cunning.
With rolls in the resource on the high gun. We'll see if it comes up.
Yeah, it might be interesting.
The judge will have to weigh in on that one.
Yeah, we'll have a rules check. Again, as I was explaining earlier, most rules. Questions in terms of just card interaction can generally be answered by simply reading the card text.
Yeah.
They're usually worded quite deliberately. So it's just a matter of reading through and seeing how the cards interact in that particular situation. Chooses to discard four strike to get a reroll. Hits the special. Might be thinking twice about playing out the probe. I think it's a probe he has in hand.
He discarded a probe earlier.
I think he might have another one.
Okay.
Oh, no, he can't have one. No, definitely
unless
can't have
playing
one. Oh,
unless he's playing three.
Unless he's... No, could be. No. we did have a player, actually. That's
a good answer to that. You're just discarding three cards?
Yep. Just empties his hand. Shuts him off for the turn. He's only showing one
not
damage.
Not a huge damage turn this turn, but
doesn't matter.
It's a good progression throughout the game.
He's showing one damage in play. Carl still hasn't rolled in a hide gun, and he has a resource. He's in a great position here. Has cards to discard as well. I feel like he might just be pushing for some damage here. Deals one. Conveniently to the correct character and also gets to blank a die, but the blank is probably irrelevant given that he's going to be re-rolling regardless. Yep.
Discarding survival gear here.
Snap re-rolls. It's a...
You got a disrupt and a resource?
A
money box?
I feel he's going to claim. Charles got nothing to hold up here. And then there's the re-roll
here
again.
Here comes all the cards to re-roll.
Yep, there it is. That's some damage.
That's a cunning
as well. Here we go. This might be interesting. Let's find out. Our judge is again going to step out just to make sure this happens as is described by the cards. I feel, without knowing the card text exactly, I'm not sure whether or not. Again, it's going to come down to the wording of cunning and the wording of force stroke. This force stroke does, for a fact, I know, it does specify another character, but it's interesting whether or not that is circumvented by the special of cunning. So it looks like we have some... no, it looks like we have a ruling, so it seems that cunning does not hit the special force trick on the character to which it is equipped. Very interesting corner cases coming up in this match. It's been quite entertaining. So yeah, chooses to pass there. Can't do anything with that die. So feel like you couldn't do it.
I feel like you can't do it. I'd like to see a response from FFG about that situation. But
yeah,
but right now it's played as is. It unblock. It clearly says resolve the card as if it was yours, and it's my card, and it's attached to that character, and it says another character.
Yep. Well, without any kind of precedent set, there are some weird. There are some very strange rule interactions that do come up in the current rule set of. Destiny, which I feel need to be addressed.
Well, that being said, the rules reference is actually quite comprehensive.
It is very comprehensive.
You might have to read it a couple of times, but most answers are in there.
There are a few quite rare corner cases, which I guess is the reason why we don't have answers to them just yet.
This is why I don't play cunning. I just don't want to deal with it.
It's a strong card. It's making me think twice about playing.
So Holocron focus, one damage on the radar, and then a two disrupt.
All right. So choosing not. To...
He's done with it. He's sick of all the corner cases.
Yep.
He's just going to upgrade to a DL 44.
Force him to resolve
Please
it.
Please remove a die. Ambush.
Interesting. A choice for Charles here would have been to discard card to resolve the focus, which then gives... Basically, to short it shortcuts an action.
It does. I can't quite see what's in his hand. So he's got a force he could have discarded the deflect.
He has the deflect to discard. It's basically just taking it, getting him an action in front. Presents theoretically he could have it would have been hard to play around, but he could have focused the raider to damage. He could have focused the force choke to a special. Looks like they're just calling it.
He's
there.
Looking at his hand, he's looking at a deflect.
Oh well, there's a four there.
Yeah, he's looking at the deflect, he can't do anything about it. Vader's up and left.
Falcon comes in for its second strafing round of the match and cleans up. So that is...
Congratulations, Carl.
Yeah, very well played by Carl.
Commiserations, Charles, but also very well played.
Yeah, definitely.
5-0 in Swiss.
So Charles went 5-0 in Swiss.
Carl was one of our four runs.
Was undefeated up until the final.
This is his first loss for the day.
Yep, Carl was a 4-1. Played very well. Knows the deck. Knows both the decks, obviously, quite clearly.
Yeah.
Confidence in the matchup, as with my discussion with him earlier, obviously, well-founded. Knew what he was doing. Piloted very well.
Well, I hope to see a lot more of these players. This game is so young. I like to see the good, the up-and-comers really just...
Oh, definitely. Definitely. We're getting to see some very strong players at all of our tournaments.
Who knows will be good in the next 6 months.
Oh, definitely.
We've got our good players now. We'll have a good player
later. Oh, definitely. Hopefully, more players rise up and demonstrate that they are good in the ways of the Force or the Dark Side or anything for that matter.
Yeah, the average player is very high in this game.
Yeah, definitely. And also being a game that very heavily rewards skill.
Mm.
Anyway, that's been us at General Games. You throw us a like on Facebook and subscribe to the channel. We're going to have lots of content going up quite regularly.
Yeah, it could be every couple of days. Could be every day even. We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see.
Just keep checking back to the YouTube and Facebook and Twitter, Instagram.
All the social media. And
you've been Marcus, I've been Scott, and we'll see you then.
That's us.
Bye.